Before we landed on the moon, scientists had to figure out how to keep astronauts alive once they opened the capsule door to the harsh vacuum of space. The Gemini spacesuit was built to solve this problem, and in 1965 it was worn in the Gemini 4 mission, the first American spacewalk. Let's take a look at the innovative suit that made EVA, or extravehicular activity, possible.
The Gemini suit has layers of aluminized mylar, nylon, and felt. In combination, they protect the astronaut against temperature and space particles. Special overgloves are worn to guard against extremes of space temperature if the astronaut should grasp the spacecraft during EVA. As the astronaut leaves Gemini, he is attached by a supporting umbilical line, 25 feet long. The umbilical is actually one assembly consisting of three elements: a nylon tension line, electrical wiring, and an umbilical line. The nylon line or tether is shorter than the umbilical line. It takes all loads exerted during EVA and can withstand 1,000 pounds of pull. The electrical wiring enables the astronaut to maintain direct communication with his command pilot. It also records biomedical readings for ground surgeons. The umbilical line furnishes oxygen to the suit from the spacecraft's primary oxygen system. The life support pack, mounted on the parachute harness, contains an emergency oxygen bottle. If the umbilical line should fail, the astronaut would have enough oxygen to support him for at least 9 minutes, more than enough time for him to return to the spacecraft safely in an emergency. The pilot also carries a small maneuvering unit during EVA, the so-called space gun. Designed by NASA engineers of the Flight Crew Support Division, the gun provides a limited amount of thrust from compressed oxygen for basic maneuvering experiments.
We've come a long way since Gemini, but the bones of it still exist in the spacesuits of today and tomorrow.